Good evening and welcome to the 40th annual Horace and Mary Lawrence concert. I'm William Lawrence Jr., one of your narrators for the evening. Did you know that scripture reminds us that Moses fasted for 40 days and nights to prepare himself to receive God's law?
Good evening. I am Tanya Flowers, and I am also one of the MCs tonight as we prepare to give God the praise. Did you know in the Old Testament that manna rained down on the Israelites for 40 years?
Good evening, I'm Lynn Brinkley, and I'm your final MC for this grand occasion. Did you know that after his glorious resurrection, Jesus appeared to his followers for 40 days before he ascended up to heaven?
So this evening, we invite you to prepare to receive
the Spirit raining down on us
as we give all glory and praise to the Spirit of our resurrected Lord, who has and will appear to us tonight. Welcome to the 40th annual Horace and Mary Lawrence concert.
Everybody lift your voice and say, every praise.
First of all, let me thank all who have joined us today for this 40th anniversary of the Horace and Mary Lawrence Family Concert. We appreciate you taking the time to join us in fellowship and praise. Hello there to my family. These are strange and challenging times. For most of us, we couldn't fathom being anywhere other than Chadron, North Carolina for this Labor Day Sunday. Yet, here we are, virtually gathered. But rest assured, we will not let the devil nor an orange scourge stop us from convening for this moment of praise and worship, as is our tradition. So as we proceed, we ask those of you whom have joined us for your patience and understanding. We have never done this in any virtual fashion before, and we hope that our technologies will cooperate. As we proceed, you will experience a mixture of live and recorded content. You will see and hear highlights from the past 39 years, and you will also share with us some precious moments from some of the Lawrence family members that have transitioned from labor to reward. Please pray with us and for us. We will now proceed with a scripture by Master Caleb Carter, a great, great grandchild. Prayer by Uncle Walter, a musical interlude by the incomparable J.P. on sax, and greetings from my Mary Jane.
Good evening. Today's scripture will be coming from Psalm 95, verses 1 through 6. I'll be reading from the New International Version. Come, let us sing for joy, let us to the Lord, let us shout out loud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is a great God and the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be unto God.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the rock I stand. All other ground is sacred sand. Father God, we come to thee this afternoon just to give you praise and glorify your holy name. Father, you've been good to us. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves, and we say thank you. Thank you, dear God, for being so good to us. Father God, we thank you for sparing us another year for this concert, dear God. 40 years of giving you the praise, and you are worthy, dear God. You are worthy of all the praise that we give you. Father God, we thank thee for your love. We thank thee for your mercy. We thank thee for your grace. We thank thee for your kindness. We thank thee for your patience. Father God, we thank thee for your forgiveness. Father God, we thank thee for your healing. We thank thee for your blessing. Father God, we've been through some storm this year, but we will not let it stop us from giving you the praise and the glory. Because you are worthy, dear God. You've been good. You've been good to this family, dear God. Father God, you've been good to us throughout the years, dear God. Father God, you give us a chance to display our parents and fathers' legacy, dear God. And we're going to continue to do it, dear God, with your help, dear God. Because we put everything in your hands, God. And when we put everything in your hand, we know that everything will be all right. Father God, I ask you just got this to move into it, dear God, this concert this afternoon, and let it touch somebody's heart, dear God. Touch our family heart, our friend's heart, our congregation's heart, dear God, our supporter's heart, dear God, or whoever they may be, dear God. Father God, we just thank thee for this young, new generation choir, dear God, for they are singing, picking up from the Mary Lawrence choir and singing your praise, dear God. They didn't give up, dear God. They've been through some things, dear God, and they didn't give up. And we say thank you. Thank you for being so good to us, dear God. Father God, as we move into this service this afternoon, dear God, let it be what thou would have it to be, dear God. We're not doing it for no show, but Father God, we just doing it to glorify your precious name, dear God, and give you the praise that you need, dear God. Father God, we ask thee to be with our youth, dear God, our young children, dear God, as this virus going on, this COVID virus going on, dear God. Protect them as they prepare to go back to school. Go back to school, dear God. Keep your arms of protection around them, dear God. Be with the one that's going back to college, dear God. Keep your arms of protection around them, dear God. Father God, we ask thee this to go into the hospital, or into the rest home, or wherever they may be, and touch those that lay on the bed of affliction. Let them know that you are God and you have all power in your hands. Father God, we like thank thee for the deacons and the pastor of this First Baptist Church, dear God, for the years they supported us, dear God, and allow us to come in and just give you the praise and honor, dear God, because you're worthy, dear God. You're worthy to be praised. Father God, when we are gone on by our way, dear God, the time have come to the end, God. Father God, let it be said that we fought a good fight. and we've given our heart and soul to you. And we are going to that great, great, great heavenly kingdom, God. No more pains, no more heartaches, but every day will be Sunday. These and all of the blessings we ask in your precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Good afternoon. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. My name is Mary Jane Lawrence Flowers, the fourth child of 15 children born to the late Horace and Mary Lawrence. I am currently the oldest family member living. If the Lord blesses me to see 5 more days, September the 12th, I will be 93 years old. The Lord has brought me through many storms of life, and I give him all the praise, the glory, and the honor. I just can't thank him enough. I know that it was God's grace and mercy that brought me through. For 40 years, the Lawrence family has rendered a concert for the benefit of helping some students further their education. Due to the coronavirus this year, we had to make some changes. As the oldest member of the family, it is my pleasure to welcome all of you to the Lawrence Family Concert. I hope you will receive a message from the song the family has chosen to sing. We want you to feel free to praise the Lord with us. Have a blessed evening, and we thank all of you for your continuing support.
If we call her Granny.
And this is why we do this celebration each year, to celebrate and honor and remember the legacy of our grandparents. Now we will hear a video recording from our beloved and dearly missed family member, Milton Frank, who was a gifted musician, a gifted educator, and the director of the Horace and Mary Lawrence Concert for over 30 years. Educate us, Milton.
I would like to just begin talking about the beginning of the Mary Lawrence Family Choir and how it was organized when the children of my grandmother, Mary Lawrence, decided to give her a birthday celebration when she reached her 78th birthday. And in planning the program, one of the things that the children wanted was to have a group of the children and grandchildren to provide the music for the program that they were doing for her here at First Missionary Baptist Church and celebrating her birthday. And the choir that sang for the program was made up of the children, grandchildren. And after the program, the brothers and sisters, for some reason, thought that they sound so good. They wanted to sing again. So over the next 2 years before we did our first concert, they felt that we could organize a group and put on a concert, because several people who were at the program said that we sound good, and we basically all we sung hymns, and that was basically all we did. We sang hymns, and that was all we did for the program. So when they decided that we were going to do a concert, I had to begin playing, because I was the director and the musician for the group, and I had to begin planning what are we going to sing. And so in the planning, not only did I plan for us to sing some hymns, I also planned for the group to sing some gospel music. And then we began to ask, well, what is the proceeds going to go to? So the first year, when we had our concert, the proceeds went to First Missionary Baptist Church. And then the second year, the proceeds went to Adolphus Towns, who was running for the Senate position in New York. And the folks kept saying, well, you all sound good this time, so are you gonna do it again? So really that was encouraging to the choir members and to the families. So we decided to do the concert for a third time. And then the group said, well, the proceeds that we take up for the concert, what are we gonna do with it? And that's where the scholarship came into being, to use the money for the concert to give some boy or girl that was graduating from high school an opportunity to go to college. And we felt that whatever we gave them, that would be some funds that would help them if it was nothing but to buy some books. So we began doing the concert and allowing the proceeds to go for the Mary Lawrence Scholarship Fund. And from the third concert up until our 30th concert, we have been providing a scholarship for a deserving senior in the Chadron area or the Chadron community who was planning on going to college. And let me say to you that about the fourth or fifth time that we did the concert, I was about to become frustrated with the group. I have to be honest with you. Simply because of the fact that they didn't want us to stay to choir rehearsal and rehearse in order for us to prepare for the concert. And one of my aunts, and I won't forget, my Aunt Mary Jane, who was coming here from New York, and she knew what it was like to practice in order for a choir to perform. And she kept telling the group, said, folk, you just can't get up there and sing with 1 hour rehearsal. And I was becoming frustrated and disencouraged. And so about the fourth or fifth time, my sister Mary said to me, said, Milton, said, you know, I was wanting to quit. I was wanting to give up because I was having to deal with my aunts and my uncles and my cousins about performing. And they didn't want to stay to rehearsal and practice like they should. And we didn't want to sing the same kind of music or the same music every year. And I wanted to broaden our repertoire, our selection of music, and not just sing a few hymns and one or two gospel songs. So my sister suggested to me, why don't I find someone or get someone to help me? And so someone recommended Mr. James Marley.
Okay, so to reiterate what Milton was saying, although the original choir included grandchildren and in-laws, it was mostly comprised of their children. So at this time, I would like to name and acknowledge all 15, yes, I did say 15, of Horace and Mary Lawrence's children. Edward, Sarah Lee, Mabel, Mary Jane, my mommy, Annie Lee, Blanche, Horace Jr., Baby Girl, Roosevelt, William, Patsy, Walter Lee, Napoleon, David, and the baby Clara. 15 children. What a blessing. And now we will begin part one of our concert.
My God. Some may raise the question. Come on, worship on this place. Everybody want to know.
God's great.
Everybody want to know.
God's great.
Anybody want to know.
God's
while
great.
I'm still standing.
God's great.
I made it this far.
I made it this
yes,
far.
I did, y'all.
Amen. And it is only by God's grace that we all are here. As we celebrate the 40th year of the Lawrence Family Reunion, one cannot measure the blessings our Heavenly Father has bestowed upon us. But no doubt, lots of things have happened during these years. And oh, how the world has changed during that time. Do you know that 40 years ago, GPS, the global positioning system, was initiated? It took another 20 years before it became common in cars. Today, we use it in our bare hands.
Did you realize that Turner Broadcasting debuted a 24-hour news channel 40 years ago that we now call CNN? And for you investors out there, Apple first started trading as a publicly traded stock 40 years ago.
Did you know that Pac-Man was released as an arcade game for the first time 40 years ago? 40 years ago, Venus Williams was born. The blockbuster movie, The Empire Strikes Back, was released. And 40 years ago, BET was launched as the first television network that allowed Black people to see themselves, their stories, and their culture on television. Here's the 40 years of Black.
While these were all major milestones in the history of our country, none of those are as significant to the Lawrence family as the love, commitment, and fellowship that has flourished over those same 40 years. And now let us move to the next phase of our program. This is where you all can participate. It is now time for the offering, and you should be seeing on the screen the many ways to give. You can cash app at Mary Lawrence Scholar, or you can send a good old check made out to Mary Lawrence Scholarship Fund. And you can mail that good old check to 143 Sunset Avenue, Whiteville, North Carolina, 28472. That's 143 Sunset Avenue, Whiteville, North Carolina, 28472.
Good evening, everyone. The Lawrence Family Choir is celebrating our 40th year of operation in an exciting and unique manner with this virtual celebratory program. Each year, we present two graduating seniors from West Columbus High School with a scholarship in honor of our parents and grandparents, Horace and Mary Lawrence. Our first recipient is DeLorean Deshaun Smith. He is the son of Javonda Collins and Antonio Smith. He is a member of New Life Church of Chadron. He played the drums for several local churches. At West Columbus High School, DeLorean played football, ran track, and kept stats for the basketball team. He is attending North Carolina A&T State University, majoring in engineering and music. Our second scholarship will be given in memory of my sister, Lieutenant Colonel Annie L. Lawrence, who passed in June. She was a nurse in the Air Force, and she taught nursing classes and geriatric classes at the college in Maryland. She believed in education, and she supported a lot of youth with their educational endeavors. The recipient of this scholarship in memory of Ann Lawrence is Jayla Cobbs. I will let this awesome young lady introduce herself to you.
My name is Jayla Cobbs, and I'm the daughter of John and Ann Cobbs. I'm a member of First Missionary Baptist Church, and I'm a graduate of West Commons High School, where I served as president of the Beta Club, president of SGA, and a captain of the women's soccer team. I was also a junior and senior marshal of my graduating class. I graduated West Columbus High School at the top of my class with summa cum laude, and I was awarded Outstanding Senior by the faculty and staff. As of May 2020, I'm also a graduate of Southeastern Community College, where I received an Associate in Science degree. This fall, I'm attending the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill as a biology major.
As Tanya said, this is a moment where everyone can participate and contribute. As you can see, we will not let a pandemic stop the legacy of giving and sharing with our communities that has been a part of our family for all these years. So we look forward to your contributions and say thank you. So for those out there who are watching and may not be familiar with the history, this has truly been a labor of love and sacrifice for the Harriet, Horace, and Mary Lawrence Choir. While most of us think of this weekend as the end of summer and a time to unwind, the members of this choir would travel to Chadburn prepared to spend hours on Friday evening and most of the day on Saturday practicing for this concert. They came from many places, New York, Maryland, Florida, Virginia, and other places, with the words to the songs already in their hands, but fully with the expectation that they would have to prepare their voices to be collectively lifted in praise. From inception until 2005, the original Mary Lawrence Choir performed. Starting in 2006, younger members of the family created the New Generation Choir, which took flight and began doing split duty during the concerts. After 2010, the torch was formally passed on.
So it didn't seem like 30 years, but we did it. And I regret that we couldn't do it any longer, but it's time for somebody else to take over. So the younger generation has taken over, and we do hope that they will continue to carry it out.
Well, Aunt Sarah, we hope that we have made you and the rest of our aunts and uncles proud by continuing to lift up the Lord in song and by never forgetting those that paved the way for us. We will now begin the second part of our concert.
Marvelous, 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 marvel
you, Xavier and Saray. That was awesome. And I don't think we'll ever forget our cousin Marshall picking up Xavier before the show was over and Dante having to go grab him back. That was a classic memory in our family. If you have been blessed so far by the 40th Horace and Mary Lawrence concert, right now, why don't you just stop and pause and give God some praise. Thank God for the technology working. Thank you for Monique Jowers behind the scene, working on our technology. It's just been awesome. I hope you have been blessed so far. We're going to continue in the final phase now of our concert this evening with song selections first by our beloved family member who is gone but not forgotten, our Uncle David Lawrence, followed by Made a Way, sung by the best principal in the state of North Carolina, Jason Jowers. Then we will have another mime by Born to Worship Ministry. Then we will hear Lord Do It, sung by Sharmika Menifee and Sharon Peel. Then we will have acknowledgments by our family communications director, Lori Lawrence. And then Pastor Colleen Kelly, the family pastor. Oops, excuse me, Pastor Colleen Kelly, fault, because she's married now. She's going to come and bring our closing remarks, followed by our closing song by the original and New Generations Choir together. And then our deacon will come, Deacon Dante Kelly, and lead us in our closing prayer. And I will come back and offer our benediction. Take it away, Uncle David.
Is anybody grateful tonight that God made a way? I'm standing here not knowing how to get through this test, but holding on to faith you know best. Cause nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out and watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, you wrapped us in your arms and you stepped in. Cause everything we need you supply. You got this in control. And now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. Oh, you made a way. Say, I don't know how. 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 And I don't know why. So now I'm standing here only because you made. I said I'm standing here only because, in spite of my sins, I'm standing here only because you made a way. I'm standing here only because you made. Won't you say I'm standing here only because you. I'm standing here, it's only, I'm standing here, only.
Oh! Lord, do it. Good evening, family and friends. At this time, we will acknowledge our family accomplishments, and it always goes from Labor Day, the Sunday Labor Day, until the Friday before the next Labor Day. So, in September, The matriarch of our family, Mary Jane Flowers, did celebrate her 92nd birthday. Glory to God, we pray that she will be able to celebrate her 93rd birthday next weekend. Happy birthday, Aunt Mary Jane. In December, Monica Brown received her associate degree in Applied Science Clinical Trials Research, cum laude, Certificate of Advancement Clinical Trials Research Associate, cum laude, and Certificate of Core Competencies Clinical Trials Research Associate, magnum cum laude. On Christmas Day, Delmas Tyrone Falk proposed to Colleen Tootie Kelly and were married in April on the 11th. In January, Carolyn Lawrence Brinkley was called as Associate Director of Baptist Women in Ministry, a national organization based in Atlanta, Georgia. William Lawrence Jr. and Gina Robinson are engaged and are planning an October 21 wedding. In May, Mary's birth baby celebrated her 70th birthday. In June, Chris and Monica celebrated their 25th wedding anniversary. Also, our 2020 COVID graduates. Kirsten Neely Campbell graduated from Ashley High School and is currently attending UNC Pembroke, majoring in nursing. Emery Inman graduated from North Carolina Central University with a Bachelor of Science in Family and Consumer Sciences. He is currently in graduate school. Taylor Lawrence graduated from the North Carolina A&T State University and was recently commissioned as a second lieutenant in the U.S. Air Force and will be stationed at Air Moody Air Force Base in Valdosta, Georgia as a civil engineer. Congratulations to our 2020 COVID graduates. We know it was rough, but you did it. And as Aunt Ann would say, you get an A. Mary Spate passed the life license exam and her application is in its final stage of approval for insurance licensing in the state of North Carolina. The next step is licensing in other designated states and a securities license by the end of 2020. Darian David Allen, the family calls him Tank, is the owner of Whip Appeal Motors LLC by DJ. This is located at 2100 Holloway Street in Durham, North Carolina. And hot off the press, Waitisha Carter has launched Good Doctor Creations LLC, featuring Good Doctor Jams, honoring the jam-making legacy of her grandmother, Aunt Blanche Lawrence Frink. She can be reached via email at gooddoctorcreations@gmail.com for product info and pricing. And again, family, if I didn't acknowledge it, you know, you didn't tell me. Thank you.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. I am here to do the remarks and the closing remarks. And so if we were in First Missionary Baptist Church, we would be saying thank you to Reverend Virgil Rees and the deacons of First Missionary Baptist Church and their deacons and trustees. But as my uncle said in the prayer, which is so awesome, thanking you all for the years that you have allowed our family to be in First Missionary Baptist Church to celebrate this great occasion, part of our kind of kickoff, the highlight of our family reunion. And so I say thank you to them. I would like to say thank you to the choir directors from the past and currently, my uncle, the late Milton Frank, who allowed me to come on in 1997 with him and James Marley, Mr. James Marley. I thank God for these men. They said they wanted some help. So you will see the two of them, Mr. Marley on the piano, Mr. Frank on the organ, and then they will allow me to direct some of their songs. And I did most of their gospels for them, or as my Uncle Milton said, the contemporary music. And he would say, you know, you gotta keep me on beat. And then after he allowed us, after we kind of took over and transitioned, God allowed us to have Sister Tiffany Spencer to come join us, and we're excited. Tiffany has been with us since a little bit before 2011, believe it or not, but she's been directing since then fully with the choir, teaching songs and everything. And so we will also tell you the musicians that you got to see along the way. DeVito Austin started out with us years ago. Also, the late Brian Howie was a drummer for us. Brian Powell played the keyboard, and also Byron is our keyboard player. Byron teach music for us, and so we just thank God for Byron stepping in. Anthony Kemp has played the bass guitar for us. Again, David Spencer has been on the organ with us for years, keyboard, whatever we need him to do, he's been there also. Also, we want to thank Willie Bellamy, who's been our bass guitar player. Again, James Marley on the piano and the organ, Mr. Frank again on the piano and the organ. Those two guys did double duty all those years. They played and they direct. And then we had Dontrell McDuffie, who played the piano. A guest drummer for us was Damir Watson. And then our original drummer, who plays the drums, the bass, everything, Eric Green. And then Jashawn Peel, who has been with us throughout the start as our saxophone player. So those are the musicians that have played with the Horace and Mary Lawrence Choir, the original choir, and the new generation. Again, I want to say thank you to my narrators. And for a second, if everybody could you put your cameras on, because I just want to throw a shout out to the narrators. Can we clap, give it up for those narrators? If you're in your home, wherever you are, Dr. William Lawrence Jr., Miss Tanya Flowers, Dr. Lynn Brinkley, we want to say thank you all. Job well done. And the words of our Aunt Anne again, you guys get an A. You get an A today. So we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. And so again, just put on the cameras before you can see that. If you see our family, normally we would be in some color. This year we were planning to be in red dresses and the guys in black suits and red bow ties. And so that we could kind of look back like the original choir, but instead we are in red family t-shirts. If you don't see, a screen will come up at the end to show you how you can still get out from our virtual store. But we are excited about these family reunion t-shirts. We try to make it as normal as possible. So we was able to create and allow our family to get family reunion t-shirts. And so if you want to be a part of that, again, thank you. Those of you who are sewing, again, to send it in the mail or our Cash App, just continue to sew throughout the year. You don't have to stop just today. You can continue to sew and send in your seed to the scholarship fund. We have given over, I don't want to say the incorrect number, but I'm pretty sure we started in 1982 giving out scholarships. And so we've been doing it ever since to someone in the Columbus County area who graduated from West Columbus High School. West Columbus High School has been our feeder school. And so that's where we've been able to give back at. And so again, I want to say thank you to some special people. I cannot forget about them. And I just want you to stand still for the name of this group is the H&M Lawrence Virtual Staff and Committee. That is the Horace and Mary Lawrence Virtual Staff and Committee. And I just wanted to give the roll call to let you know who those awesome people are. Claire Lawrence Dunn, Mary Spate, Lori Lawrence, Monica Brown, Dante Kelly, Waitisha Carter, I'm skipping a name for a reason, Jashawn Peel, and Miss Taylor Lawrence. But last but not least, our virtual, I could say so many different names, but since we're live, I'm going to Monique Jowers. This is the one who put this all together for us. Can y'all give it up for Monique Jowers? Thank you for your willingness and your humble spirit to serve and to make sure it worked. So she was behind the scenes. And then also myself was a part of the team. But I just thank everybody. And again, we thank all of you for watching us today. This was different for us. We were probably more nervous about this virtual concert than what we put on First Sunday. I'll be honest and tell you the truth. We were more nervous about this than First Sunday. But God's willing, 2021. And if First Baptist still allow us to come, which I think they will, God's willing, we want to be back at First Missionary Baptist Church in Chadburn, North Carolina at 5:30 p.m. to do this again. I think every moving part of this concert, every moving part, we thank everybody who played a role. And we just want you to understand the transition of where we're going from the original and the new generation. And we pray that we can continue to move forward as what has been laid into us. This is a great responsibility. We pray we continue to make our family proud and do as they've always wanted us to do. And last thing, I wrote it down. So as Dr. Brinkley just said, that closing song tonight is so powerful, because that is actually the last time that we all came together. We came together one more time in 2010. But in 2006, that was majority of everyone still around. At that time, we had only lost Uncle David. And so to have the original choir and the new generation choir come together, there was no better way for us to close this concert out today with those two groups and letting you know how we wouldn't be here without them. And we were able to continue their legacy. So we thank each one of you again. Stay on and watch the closing videos and the prayers. But again, to God be the glory.
Thank you, God, for this day. We thank you, God, for bringing us together, God. God, we say yes to your will and yes to your way, God. God, we just look over, we just thank you, God, for the 40 years, God, of bringing us together as a family, God. You've continued to bless and you've continued to move in a mighty way in this family, God. God, we've had ups, we've had downs, but God, you've been there, God. You've been our rock, God. You've been our continuous rock, God. You've been there for us all the time, God. You've given us your grace, God, and your mercy, God. You've been a marvelous God to us, God. God, you've been through, we've been through things and we've been through a lot of things, God, and you've been there for us, God, and we thank you for, God. We thank you for doing it for us, God. We thank you for making a way for us, God. We thank you just for being in our lives, God, and continue to bless this family, God. God, I ask you right now, God, to look on each and every one of us, God, that we go through these trying times that we have gone through already right now, God, and we've been blessed, God. We've continued to be blessed, God, because we are still moving on, God. We are still carrying on. We're still giving you all the honor and all the glory, God. God, we are virtual right now, God, but we're going to continue, God. We thank you, God, for just being a marvelous God for us, just doing it for us, God, continuously, God. And we thank you and we appreciate you, God. And oh, God, I really want to thank God for our aunts and our uncles, God, our mothers and our fathers, God, that they laid the foundation for us, God. They've laid the foundation and continue to lay the foundation, and we're continuing to grow it, God. And God, I ask each and every one of us, God, to just to continue to do the things that you know that God has put you on this earth to do, God. There is something that we have, God, that we know we can do, God, and we thank you for that, God. Each and every one of you, God, there's a place that God is putting you, need to put you in, and he's taking you to that level, and we thank you for pushing you into your destiny, God, pushing us into our destiny, God. God, I thank you for each and every person that joined in with us, God, online, God. I ask you to bless them, God. Continue to move in their families, God. Continue to strengthen their families. Build their families up where they feel like they've been torn down, God. God, we've gone through sicknesses. We've gone through diseases. And we've gone through deaths, God. But God, you've been there with us, God. You've been holding our hand, God, continuously, God. And we thank you, God. We thank you for holding our hand and keeping us, God. Oh, my God, I thank you right now, God, for each and every person that is connected to this family. Cousins, aunts, and uncles, God, everyone that is connected, God. Bless each and every one of us, God. God, bless us in our dark places, God, that we've been in. Bless us in our places that we feel like there's no one else that can help us out, God. But we know you can help us, God, because your continuous mercy has been with us, God. And we thank you for that, God. We thank you for each and every person, God, that has been able to come together with us today, God. We honor you, we appreciate you, and we love you. And God, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for this day, God. Thank you, Lord, for this day, God. Thank you, Lord. I thank you and I honor you and I appreciate you. In your name we pray and we say amen.
Yeah, amen. Go now in the spirit of the ancestors whose legacy lives through us. Go now with anger, fighting for justice, racial equality, and the right to vote that our ancestors died for. Go walking in love, that same love that has sustained this family for over 40 years. Now may the grace of God be with you, the strength of Christ keep you, and may the spirit of the living God be with you today and in the days to come. Amen.
just begun to get our share of this world's delight. High hopes we have for the future and our goals in sight. We know we don't get depressed. Here's what we call our golden rule. Have faith in you and the things you do. You won't go wrong. Oh no, this is our family jewel. We are.
Again, everybody, for joining us. We're going to try to get this video posted either tonight or tomorrow on our YouTube page. Until then, have a great night. God bless you.